डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर ज्योत्सना शिवसागर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जेनेटिक्स एंड प्लांट ब्रीडिंग. नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग सोमैटिक एम्ब्रियोजेनेसिस. इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी आर डिस्कसिंग द माइक्रो प्रोपगेशन ऑफ प्लांट्स. इन फर्स्ट स्लाइड्स वी आर सीइंग दिस examples of embryos of different crops. First one is a cotton, second one is a soybean, and third one is a ohio bank bunchy. Then somatic embryogenesis is the formation of an embryo from a cell other than a gamete or the products of gametic fusion. In a nature, embryogenesis being from the time of fertilization and the prolongs until dormancy occurs. Embryogenesis is similar in all angiosperms in terms of the establishment of the basic body plan. While the zygote is the first diploid cell of the process generated through the fusion of male and female gametes, the embryo is the earliest recognizable multicellular stages of an individual that occurs before it has developed the characteristics or organs of a given species. By Gray in the year 1996. The embryo is a bipolar structure, and during embryogenesis, shoot and root meristem are initiated. Then this basic in definition or the meaning of somatic embryogenesis means in these slides we are only discuss the what is the somatic embryogenesis, meaning of this word. Somatic means a body cells. Any kind of plant cells other than gametes is called as a somatic. It is the cells is called as a germ lines. Embryogenesis means embryo formation process, means the formation of embryo is called as embryogenesis. Whole word is meaning of whole word somatic embryogenesis is any kind of plant part cells other than gametes or the formation of embryo is called as somatic embryogenesis. Now we are seeing the scientific definition of somatic embryogenesis is the developmental pathway of numerous well-organized small embryoids resembling the zygotic embryos from the embryogenic potential somatic cell of a callus tissue or cells of the suspension culture is known as somatic embryogenesis. Or another definition is somatic embryogenesis is the formation of an embryo from the cell other than the gamete or the product is of the gametic fusion. It is a simple definition of somatic embryogenesis. Meaning of embryogenic potential is the capacity of somatic cell of a culture to produce embryoids is known as embryogenic potential. Then different types of embryos. Cohen Bech in the year 1978 has proposed the following classification of the embryos. Embryos has two type. One is the zygotic embryos and second one is the non-zygotic embryo. Zygotic embryo, those formed by the fertilized egg or the zygote is called as the zygotic embryos. And second one is the non-zygotic embryo. Those embryo formed by a cell other than zygote is called as non-zygotic embryos. Again, this non-zygotic embryo classified, first one is the somatic embryos, second one is the parthenogenic embryos, and third one is the endogenic embryos. First one is the somatic embryos, those formed by a sporophytic cells other than either in vitro or in vivo. Second one is the parthenogenic genetic embryos, those formed by a unfertilized egg. This called as the parthenogenic embryos. Third one is the androgenic embryos, those formed by the male gametophyte, means the microspores, pollen grains. This called as the androgenic embryos. Then difference between the zygotic and somatic embryo is the some variables are considered for this somatic and zygotic differentiation. First one is a form by, means this is the form by the sporophytic cells, and this is the form, zygotic embryo is formed by a fertilized egg or the zygote, and somatic embryos formed by a sporophytic cells. Means a formation of somatic embryo with the help of sporophytic cells, and zygotic embryo is formed with the help of fertilized egg or the zygote. Then second one is the somatic embryos covered by no covering, means somatic embryos not having the seed coat, and the zygotic embryo covered by the seed coat. Then somatic embryos output only from the embryo, and the zygotic embryo output is the seed. Means from the somatic embryo you get only the embryo, but zygotic embryo gets a seed or got the seeds. Then somatic embryo nature of the plantlet is weak, but a zygotic embryo nature of the plantlet is healthy, and somatic embryos are like a mother plant, means somatic embryo plants are look like same, exactly similar to the these mother plants. Then zygotic embryo is not like a mother plant, it is not look like his mother. Then somatic embryo is a propagated rate is high, but zygotic embryo propagation rate is comparatively low than the somatic embryo. Then this is the morphological development of the cells or the somatic embryo or the zygotic embryo. First, in a somatic embryo, first the cells is undergoes the callus formation, then callus is afterwards a globular, look like a globular, and then it is converted into the heart or the torpedo shape, and then you get the plantlet, and this regeneration then again you get the regeneration of whole plants. In zygotic embryogenesis, first you get the zygote, then this zygote undergoes the globular shape, then heart or the torpedo shape, and then this heart shape is converted into the cotyledon, and then onwards cotyledon you get the expansion, maturation, desiccation and dormancy stage, and afterwards a germination of the plantlet, and then growth is developed or the whole procedure is completed. Then next is a type of embryogenesis. These are the two type of embryogenesis. First one is zygotic embryogenesis and second one is the somatic embryogenesis. The what is the zygotic embryogenesis? The zygotic embryogenesis is formed following double fertilization of ovules, forming the plant embryo and the endosperm, which together go on to the develop into the seed. Means this zygotic embryo gets the from zygotic embryo is a last product or end product is a seed, and this process is known as the zygotic embryogenesis. And this zygotic embryo get from the double fertilization, of ovule, and then you get the zygotic embryo. And these seeds may also develop without fertilization through the pathway referred to the apomixis. Means you get the seeds may also develop without fertilization through the pathway, and this process is called as the apomixis. Then second one is the somatic embryogenesis. When embryos regenerate from a somatic cells or the body cells or the tissues which are haploid, diploid, etc., it is a term as somatic embryogenesis. Some somatic embryogenesis is the process by which the somatic cells or the tissue develops into a differentiated embryos. This is called as a somatic embryogenesis. Somatic embryogenesis was the first induced in a suspension culture in the year 1958 by Stewards, and in a callus culture. Firstly, pioneer work is done from the scientist Rinert in the year 1958 in the crop carrot. In addition to the members of Umbelliferus and Solanaceous, a range of dicotyledonous family have produced a somatic embryos. Somatic embryos occurs most frequently in a tissue culture and as an alternative organogenesis for the regeneration of whole plants. This is the morphological stages of somatic embryogenesis in the alfalfa. First one is the stage of callus, then heart shape, then torpedo shape, and this is the leaf shape or the developmental stage. This one is the development of small somatic embryo cells. Then somatic embryogenesis pathway. This pathway is two ways. One is the direct somatic embryogenesis and second one is the indirect embryogenesis. Direct embryogenesis, cells of explant directly undergoes the embryogenesis in the absence of callus proliferation. In direct somatic embryogenesis, you not get the callus. You directly get the embryos. Indirect somatic embryogenesis, cells of explant first undergo the callus proliferation and embryoids develop within the callus tissue. Then root of somatic embryogenesis. What is the root of somatic embryogenesis? These are the two roots of somatic embryogenesis. One is the direct embryogenesis and second one is the indirect embryogenesis. Direct embryogenesis means what? The embryos initiate directly from the explants in the absence of callus. And indirect embryogenesis means the callus from the explant take place from which the embryos are developed. Then types of embryogenetic cells. Embryos is again classified or the categories into two. One is the pre-embryogenic determined sales, PEDCS. The sales are committed to embryonic development and need only to be released. Such cells are found in a embryonic tissue. This is called as a pre-embryonic determined cells. Induced embryogenic determined cells. In the majority of cases, embryogenesis is a through indirect method. The specific growth regulators, concentrations and or culture conditions are required for initiation of a callus and then redetermination of these cells into the embryogenic pattern of the development. This is called as induced embryogenic determined cells. What is the direct somatic embryogenesis? In direct somatic embryogenesis, the embryoids are formed directly from the cells or small group of cells without production of an intervening callus coming among the reproductive tissues. It is rare in a comparison with the indirect embryogenesis. Means mostly indirect method is applied in a somatic embryogenesis. Then direct embryogenesis, this is some information about the direct information. Direct somatic embryogenesis is the initiation media. You use the initiation media. In direct somatic embryogenesis, the immature zygotic embryos or the embryo parts are placed on a 2,4-D induction medium. Means for a direct embryogenesis, you take auxins like a 2,4-D for the induction medium. These are moved to the development medium without 2,4-D but supplemented with the ABA, gently dehydration step may help a somatic embryos to germinate. In this diagram, we see or the flowchart, you see the firstly take a initiation medium in which you grow the leaf parts. Initial medium includes the 2,4-D, and then next one is the developmental medium. In this medium, you do not add the 2,4-D. Then you get the globular stage. Then developmental, next one is the development medium in which you add the ABA and or the sugar, and you get the cotyledon stage. Means you provide the carbohydrate to the our plants, and then afterwards you put your then cotyledon stage put into the KCL partial desiccation, and then you put into the your growing media and you get the germination and growth regulations. Means you do not add the any growth regulators in our media. You just only go through the simply germination. Then next is a direct embryogenesis, and this is the two protocols or the procedures of direct embryogenesis and indirect embryogenesis. Firstly, you take a explant. In both the protocols, you take the firstly explant. Then afterwards, culture of explants in a medium. Means you take explants and then culture into the medium, appropriate medium, and then you get the in direct embryogenesis you get the embryoids, and in indirect embryogenesis you get the callus formation. And then afterwards in direct embryogenesis your embryoids are mature, undergo the maturation, and in indirect embryogenesis your callus formation is undergoing to the embryos. And then afterwards one by one procedures is followed germination and then you get the complete plant in a both protocol or the both procedures. Then examples of direct somatic embryogenesis. Somatic embryogenesis has been reported from many plants such as a coffee, then carrot, then brassica, and then groundnut, then leaves, scutellum, then hypocotyles, nucellus, and embryo sac, etc. are used as the example in a direct embryogenesis. Then these pictures is, you see, this is the direct embryogenesis examples of cassava. Then next one is the indirect somatic embryogenesis. Is some examples and how to get or which explant is used in a indirect somatic embryogenesis. Indirect embryogenesis, callus is the first produced from the explant. Firstly, you produce the callus and then you get the shoots. And this is the example of indirect shoot formation from the callus of tobacco. Embryoids can then be produced from the callus tissue or from the cell suspension produced from the callus. Then next one is the indirect somatic embryogenesis. This is the protocol of the indirect somatic embryogenesis. Seedling tissue is induced to form a polyembryonic masses in the liquid culture containing 2,4-D. Then polyembryonic masses can be sized using a screen mesh from the uniformity before being placed on a development medium without 2,4-D. First one, you take a initiation medium, you add the 2,4-D, then you get the callus formation, and then polyembryonic masses in a liquid culture, then growth your callus or polyembryonic masses in a liquid medium. Then you, after polyembryonic development, then your masses is screen or the mesh into the filter, and then develop the medium. And you put explant on a developmental medium, and then germination, and you do not add the growth regulator, or your medium is free from the growth regulators, and you get the leaflet or the leaf or plantlets. This is the procedure of indirect somatic embryogenesis. And in last slide, we are discussing the direct somatic embryogenesis protocol or procedure. This is the procedure of a indirect embryogenesis in soybean. Firstly, first take a seed of immature seed of soybean, then induce induction is occur, then you put your explant into the culture medium or the growing medium, and then it gets the callus, and then afterwards you get the callus, then your callus is proliferated, and then afterwards you get the develop the shoots from your callus, and then afterwards germination is occur, and then afterwards you get the plant or the whole plant late of your crop. This is the procedure of the indirect embryogenesis. Then this is also example of callus proliferation in a ginger. You take a ginger explant of birds, then after these buds, taking a buds put into the culture medium, you get the callus. After that callus, you get the shoots of your embryos. Then somatic embryogenesis, embryos are induced to form an vegetative tissues. They can be used for a clonal propagation or to recover genetically transformed plants. Means you get a same or the exact copy of mother in somatic embryogenesis. Then somatic embryogenesis having the four stages. One is the induction, second one is the development, third one is the conversion, and fourth one is the germination. Then in a induction stage, usually it's required the 2,4-D, means the auxin. Auxin is the used as a induction medium or the emerging or the it's a development of the cells. Then concentration of auxin and cytokinin is equal, then you get the callus. Then second one is the development stage. In it inhibits by a 2,4-D and is often enhanced by the ABA. Means you use the ABA for the developing the your cells or the maturation of the cells. And this this is the second stage, developmental stage. Third one is the cotyledon stage. And then removal of 2,4-D from the media and add the ABA allow the propagation of embryogenesis to the heart and cotyledon stage of embryogenesis. This is the third stage. And fourth one is the third stage, and it is the conversion preparation. Prepare the embryo for germination and can be added by the desiccation. Means you use the KCL for the desiccation. Then in germination, usually proceed normally, but gibberellin can be used to enhance the germination. Means you increase the rate of germination with the help of gibberellin. Then after germination, a plantlets can be formed. Means after germination, you get the plant. Then some factors are affecting the growth of somatic embryogenesis. First one is the growth regulators. A number of factors have been shown to have a profound effect on somatic embryogenesis. The most important chemical factors involves in the medium are auxin and reduce the nitrogen. Then auxin, somatic embryogenesis in a carrot is a classical example. It is a two-step process. The minimal level of auxin is essential for the induction of embryogenic potential cells within the cultural tissues, but for the organogenesis and the maturation of the embryoids from the embryogenic potential cells, auxin does not play a positive role. Then carbon source and the concentration. In soybean, low sucrose concentration 5 and 10 gram per liter promotes the somatic embryogenetic regeneration. In alfalfa, use of maltose as a carbon source improves the somatic embryogenesis inductions and maturation. For the nitrogen source, ammonium nitrate 10 mole per liter has a promotive effect on somatic embryogenesis, and NO3 can be used, ammonium nitrate and ammonium sulfate. Then low pH in the range of 4 to 5-8 gives the higher growth of somatic embryogenesis. Genotype of explant means you use a carrot and alfalfa. Every explant shows the embryogenic potential. Embryogenic potential is confined to embryonal or the highly juvenile tissues. The type of explants. Which type of explants you used? Immature zygotic embryogenesis have been found to be a best example explant for the embryogenesis. Means you use the zygotic embryos. Then some other factors are affecting the somatic embryogenesis is a high potassium level and low dissolved O2 or the oxygen level promotes the somatic embryogenesis genetic regenerations in a citrus media. And some volatile compounds like ethanol inhibits the somatic embryogenetic regenerations. Then this is the some examples of a somatic embryogenesis. One old day is a first own old day, isolate the shoot apex and then with the primordial leaves, and after 1 week old examples explant showing the bulge meristem. There's a bulge meristem portion and expanded primordial leaves, and then 3rd week old meristematic mass shows the multiple buds and leaf initiation, then individual buds producing 2 to 8 translucents, then and then each of the tissues stratum giving a rise to the many somatic embryogenesis, and this is the many embryogenetics, and the meristematic clumps shows the differentiating buds and germinating somatic embryo shows the shoots, and this shows the shoots and plantlets with well-formed roots, plantlets from the well-formed roots, and then in a magneta box, there's a magneta box, and then acclimatization of a plantlets in a growth chamber, and regenerated plant seeds in a greenhouse. This is the whole procedure or the protocol of the somatic embryogenesis. Then what are the applications of somatic embryogenesis? Somatic embryogenesis may replace micropropagation for the rapid propagations of economically important plants. Somatic embryos can meet a specific breeding objectives by rapidly multiplying germ plant plasm that is initially present as embryonic materials. Rising a somaconal variation from a tree species. Synthesis of artificially synthetic seeds. These are the some applications. And a source of regenerable protoplast system. Embryogenic callus suspension culture. Some have been employed as a sources of protoplast isolation for a range of species. Then next one is the new cell is usually degenerated during the development of the seeds, but in a citrus species, embryogenic callus derived from a new cell remains totipotent for many years, can be used as source material for the regeneration of plants. Non-chemical mutants may be obtained through the adventitive embryogenesis in tissue culture as somatic embryos develop from a single cells. Disease-free plants can be obtained by using the new cellus embryos. The possibility of chimeric embryos arising from the transformed and non-transformed tissues of the callus can be by a pass through a process of repetitive somatic embryogenesis. The repetitive embryogenesis is of a potential use in a synthesis of metabolites such as pharmaceutical and oils. Thank you so much, everyone.